Hello, and welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on setting ad hoc options in SmartView. You can set ad hoc options to control how ad hoc actions are performed or how ad hoc grids are displayed. There are two types of options, global options and sheet options. You open the options dialog box from the SmartView ribbon. You can set global options, such as advanced options, cell styles, and extensions. Global options apply to the entire current workbook and to any workbooks and worksheets that you later create. Let's explore advanced options. You set the URL for your shared connection here. You also can specify other general behaviors, and you can set options for logging, display, compatibility, and mode. Let's explore cell styles. You specify cell styles to apply visual cues, such as font, background color, and border format to members or data cells in grids. Expand planning and data cells. Expand common. There are many formatting choices that you can apply to your grid. Notice that read-only cells are displayed in gray. Let's explore extensions. Here you see a list of the extensions you can use to leverage SmartView functionality with Oracle products. With member options, you can specify how you want member and dimension cells to be displayed in grids. When you set member options, you set a sheet option. Sheet options also include data options and formatting options. Sheet options are specified for worksheets and are the default option for new worksheets in the current workbook and for any new workbooks. However, changes to sheet level settings do not affect existing worksheets or workbooks. You can set member options, such as the zoom-in level or member name display. You can also specify whether an ancestor is displayed on the top or the bottom, whether hierarchy levels are indented, and whether to preserve formulas and comments during queries. Let's say when we have total revenue and its descendants displayed on a form, we want to see the descendants displayed first and the total revenue member displayed after those descendants. Currently, total revenue, which is the ancestor, is displayed first. In the Options dialog box, change the ancestor position to bottom. With Data Options, you specify how you want rows and columns to be displayed in grids. When you set Data Options, you can specify the types of rows or columns you want to suppress and which values to display when there is no data. Let's change what is displayed when there is no data from pound missing to a blank. In the Replacement section, remove pound missing. Let's explore formatting options. You set formatting options to define default number formatting. You can specify a thousand separator. You can select whether to apply the defined cell style in SmartView or use Excel formatting. You can choose to automatically adjust the column width to fit the cell contents. To save your changes as the default settings, click the arrow in the OK button and select Save as Default Options. Refresh the page to see your changes. Notice that when there is no data, the cells are blank. To see the member options change, zoom out and zoom in. Notice that total revenue is displayed below its descendants. In this tutorial, you saw how to set ad hoc options. To learn more, visit the link shown here.